might be traveling by boat or by plane, and something might go wrong. You could end up stranded on an isolated place with no electricity or Wi-Fi, with no way to get off that island. You might not have any survival gear with you, and you'll just have to pray that someone will come and rescue you, somehow. From building a quality shelter to starting a fire, here are 14 useful tips to survive on a deserted island. Number 14, scavenge the wreckage. You most likely came from some type of passenger jet or large ship that had lots of supplies on it. It crashed somewhere in the ocean, and random objects might be either floating ashore or are floating out there in the ocean somewhere. This could be a crucial moment for you to gather items that you certainly won't be able to get when you're exploring the deserted island. Take just a little extra time to scavenge what few items you can find. Finding just one fully stocked suitcase could be like finding a jackpot for survival. Even things that you might think would be useless, such as empty water bottles, could prove to be very important supplies. If you don't find any extra supplies, don't worry. Survival is gonna be difficult, but it's still possible. Number 13, look for other survivors. Hopefully you weren't the only survivor during this disaster, and maybe there'll be others out there to help you get through this. Trying to survive on your own would just simply be mentally exhausting, and hopefully a few of them might have some knowledge that you don't. Don't try to handle this immense task on your own. Understand that this is a very stressful situation for them as well, and try to comfort them through this whole scenario, no matter how bad it's beginning to look. Keep your eye out for people swimming, and listen for signals that others may be trying to give. Number 12, assess the situation. Take a moment to take a deep breath and gather information on the current situation. Chances are you probably didn't survive this whole ordeal without any injuries, and if you did, well, good job. If there are others with you, see how they could be useful and what their backgrounds are. If you have a medic or nurse with you, consider yourself quite lucky. See what supplies they might have that could be useful. This isn't really the time to be selfish, but you might want to keep some of your important items like food a secret for now. Think about where in the world you might possibly be after the vessel crash, and explore the mysterious island where you're about to be living for quite some time. Does there appear to be other animals living here that you might be able to hunt? Is there any sources of clean, moving water nearby? Are there any coconuts coming from trees, etc.? These are all important questions that you need to try to find answers to rather quickly. Number 11, water. Your first and most important resource is going to be water. Depending on how hot the island is, you may have about a week to survive with no water before your body succumbs to dehydration. If it's a tropical island, there should be plenty of sources of water, and the freshest water will of course be rainwater. Your next choice would be to look for some streams of water, hopefully moving water. Although it might be moving and look fresh, it can still contain harmful parasites, but those can be killed by boiling them. Many different foods, such as coconuts, naturally contain water, which you should definitely take advantage of. If there are plants, chances are fresh water is nearby or underground, and that's where you should start digging. Other methods, such as creating a water still, uses evaporation from plants in order for you to extract their moisture. Number 10, create a shelter. If you haven't found a fresh source of water already, don't freak out. You just got there. It's time for you to build your new home. No matter what the environment is, you need to have some kind of shelter to survive. Being exposed to the elements can rapidly increase your rate of dehydration, and there's a good chance this deserted island is going to be quite hot, so shade is also going to be important. Don't expect it to be the Ritz-Carlton or anything. Grab as much wood as you possibly can and use the larger branches for the support and the smaller branches to fill in the cracks. If you were able to scavenge anything from the wreckage like a blanket, that might help you with this task. Sand or dead leaves can also work decently for a comfortable bed to lie down on. Number 9. Start a fire. If you learn how to do this, you'll stay warm, be able to cook your food, be able to disinfect water, get found by aircraft, and even keep away the bugs. The first thing you need to do is find some tinder. Not the day nap, but really dry, fine pieces of wood that will catch on fire. Build little platforms with sticks or stones to keep it off the ground. Dry coconut husk will work great for tinder. It's a good idea to have this ready for the fire once it starts to burn. Create a small groove in a large piece of wood and use a sturdy stick from the same branch to create friction in that groove. Once it begins to smoke, put some of the tinder on there and see if you can get those to begin smoking as well. Carefully blow to help it spread, and before you know it, you should have a fire from the tinder, which you will then place onto the platform. Number 8. create a signal. While the smoke might attract some attention to pilots, they might not know that people are stranded down below and need help. Somewhere near the fire, you should create a signal that says SOS or help with large rocks and sticks to get your message across. It should be large enough so that people can see it from the sky, so try to make each letter at least 10 feet long. Make sure no branches from above will block its point of view either. Number 7. Prepare for a hunt. It's back to the Stone Age, and you are going to really need to be able to hunt if you want to survive this tragic ordeal. Your body is going to need some protein if you don't want to feel weak. You can only survive off of coconuts for so long until you start to need some other real food. Grab a long, sturdy stick and begin to sharpen it with a rock in order to create a spear. If there are some streams nearby, go there first to see if you can spot any animals. See if there's any fish swimming around that you might be able to easily catch. If they're large enough, try out the spear you just made to see if you can do a little spear fishing. If that hasn't worked, keep close attention to the sounds you hear and follow them. It won't be easy, but with a sustainable food source, water, shelter, and fire, you can make it out of this alive. Also, consider going to the coastline for things such as crabs and whatnot. Number 6. Preparing your food. You must carefully prepare your food if you don't want to get sick from it. Many people watching this video have probably never killed their own food before or know how to prepare it. If you're lucky, you'd be able to hunt a wild pig or something, but then what would you do with it? You mainly want to eat the muscles of the animal, but you can also save the liver and heart to eat for later. Cook what muscles you want to eat over the open fire and save the rest by smoking it. By doing this, you can preserve it for up to a week. Hang the meat above the fire to where only the smoke is reaching it. If somehow you end up on a snow-covered island, you can also consider freezing the meat. Number 5. Avoid sunburn. If you're stuck on an island with a high UV index, you must consider how you'll protect your skin from the sun. This is where mud comes in handy. If the desert isn't completely made of sand, consider lathering up in some mud. It's been a primitive form of sunblock for centuries now, and is still used by natives around the world. You're going to be outdoors a lot, and reimagine you'll certainly realize how important it is to protect your skin. When the mud dries up, it'll leave a barrier between your skin and the sun, which you'll definitely be grateful for. Number 4. Natural bug repellent. It's very possible that bugs will drive you absolutely insane if you're trying to survive on a deserted island. In fact, it's possible the very reason the island is deserted in the first place could definitely be because of bugs. So you want to keep this in mind, not only when you're setting up your post, but also when you're exploring through the jungles or whatnot. The best way to keep bugs from getting into your shelter is by setting up a fire that produces a lot of smoke. In order to do this, try out a variety of different material and see which one produces the most smoke. This will also hopefully create more of an obvious signal to pilots who come across it. So it's just a good idea sometimes to throw different things into the fire every now and then. Number 3. Try not to stray too far. We all know how it works. As soon as you leave a party, something wild happens that all your buddies talk about, and you were the only one who missed it because you decided to leave early. Well, it could be like that too if you stray too far away from the campsite of your shelter. You can probably imagine that as soon as you leave your post, Hugh Hefner shows up to the island with his private jet, search helicopters, and bikini models to rescue you. But you weren't there because you decided you were bored of the same spot. The more you move around, the better of a chance you have of getting lost or injured. Once your camp is established, only venture off a little bit in order to search for food or essential items. Number 2. Try to stay sane. We understand that it could possibly drive you insane, but you gotta try to do your best to not completely lose it. Try to think of some things you did way back in the day when you lived in an urban area that was fun, and do your best to recreate it. If you like something like baseball, grab a tree limb and find an orange and take a swing. Unless you really, really need that orange, then eat it. If you like things like dancing, then dance to the rhythm of the ocean. Try to do something that will keep you from completely going mad. And at least, try to make the illusion that you're just on an extended vacation. Number 1. Build a raft. You might have spent weeks on the island, and it's starting to seem that no one will ever come to rescue you. Your only chance to get off this island might be to build a raft and hope for the best. At this point, it could certainly be worth the risk, and completing a sturdy raft should only begin once you start to have a steady food supply, water, and fire to help you out. You can start to use some vines you come across as ropes and some extra logs that you have that aren't too heavy to form the raft. Make sure you thoroughly test the raft out on shallow water before you attempt to venture off into the deep blue seas.
Any suggestions on future videos? Let us know in the comment section, and maybe your video will be featured next.